Hi all, good morning. Welcome to TOSCA training course. In today's session, we'll have a high level description on what is automation testing, what are the different automation tools available in the market, and why should people shift from the existing tools like Selenium or UFT to TOSCA, like what are the advantages and what are the features of using TOSCA as an automation tool. Okay. So whenever you're testing an application, right, basically we test the application so that application is a highly quality product and meet the customer requirements and also user friendly. Okay. So when coming to software industry, testing can be performed in two ways. One is called as a manual testing and the other one is called as the automation testing. So we are all aware of the manual testing process. So basically what happens in a manual testing is a test engineer sits in front of the computer. Okay, the test engineer sits in front of the computer and he will try to execute the scripts. So for a test engineer to execute the test scripts or to test the application, the input required is the test cases. These test cases are written manually, and by looking at each and every test case, he will execute each and every step in the test case. And if the test case is meeting, means we have two criteria. One is the actual expectations and the met expectation, or the actual value and the expected value. When both the actual value and expected value is matching, then we say the application is passed or the test step is passed. So actual value is something which we see on the application which we are testing, and the expected is what we have written in the test case. When both the actual and expected matches, then we pass that particular test case. So as the number of test cases increases or the complexity of the application increases, it requires a lot of time to do manual testing. And when there is a case to execute application on multiple environments and multiple platforms, like we need to execute application on Windows operating system, you need to execute and you need to test the application on Linux operating system or Mac operating system, then it becomes practically impossible to test the with quality and deliver to market on time. To overcome this scenario, people have shifted to the next level of our testing, which is called as automation testing. What happens in automation testing is basically you are taking the help of a tool to execute your test cases. You focus mainly on writing the test cases with the help of some programming language or with the help of some tool, and this tool will take care of execution. The tedious job of executing the test cases is taken care by the tool itself. Okay. And coming to automation, right, we'll be focusing on three concepts. First one is evolution, second one is challenges, and the third one is called as paradigm shift in test automation. Let me go to that slide. Earlier, when automation has evolved, like if you look at the old tools like WinRunner or QTP or UFT, they basically started with a concept called as record and playback feature. So record and playback feature is a very fragile model, like it cannot accept changes, maintenance is very high. So it is generally ideally not used in the industry to this model, the first generation, which is record and playback. Then people started shifting to framework based, like you have different types of frameworks like modular framework, keyword driven framework, data driven framework, and hybrid framework. And coming to Selenium, there are frameworks like page object model. And using different design patterns, you can come up with your frameworks and behavior driven framework using Cucumber and SpecFlow. Like there are different frameworks which has taken the second generation. Like using these frameworks, they have started automating the application. When I say the application, it can be a web based application or a Windows based application. Okay. And one drawback of using this framework, okay, the advantage of using automation framework is it has overcome this fragileness. Like it is very flexible. It is not rigid like where you have in record and playback, and maintenance is comparatively less when compared to first generation model, which is a record and playback. Okay. But the challenge with the second generation, like this test automation framework, is for designing the automation framework is an expensive process. You require highly skilled resources for designing the framework or working on the framework. So next comes a concept called as model based generation. It's the third level of software test automation evolution. Basically, what happens in model-based generation is, like your focus, the TOSCA falls under this category, which is called as model-based generation. The advantage is, like it is robust, cost effective and scalable. So some of the challenges which have been faced in the earlier generation, like generation 1 and generation 2, have been overcome in generation 3 using model based testing. Okay, so as I said, you some of the challenges are like if you are working on automation framework, you require skilled resources. You need to invest in senior and highly skilled resources to get continuous benefits. Okay, and specialized skill set, like for example, if you are working on a framework on a page object model, you should have a skill set of a developer who can design a framework. So it is a bit challenging to find out people in the testing domain having developer skill set. Okay, a specialized skill set brings challenges during transition, and whenever there is a shift, if the person is leaving a job, then whatever knowledge he has been, that has to be shifted to the other person, which is a bit challenging and it's a time consuming process. Okay, so and one of the other challenges is like if you talk about automation, right, it is also a development activity. So basically you take a requirement and you convert that, you test that particular requirement using a programming language or with the help of a tool, and then you execute it and you get some results. Okay, so automation is a development activity, it's not a testing activity. It is treated as a development activity. Basically you have to invest more time. Initial time to automate is very high because you need to select the tool, you need to design the framework, and this takes a lot of time. Okay, and basically what happens is like ever evolving an application oriented frameworks reduce reliability. If the application is keep on changing, then the reliability will come down. So we need to build a framework in such a way that it is highly maintenance. Okay, so we need to build a framework to reduce the maintenance cost. It should be highly flexible. And the other things is like nowadays we are working in this agile methodology, which talks about like fail fast and fix fast concept. Okay, and rework test cases, like whenever you have to do some rework, right, there is some complexity involved in doing rework of that particular test case. So in order to overcome these difficulties, the Tosca has come up with a new model. So basically what we are going to do here is you are going to steer the components of a web application. I'll come to this point, like basically using this model, we can do automation without high maintenance or without programming. This is the reason why Tosca is becoming popular. Using Tosca, we can do automation without high maintenance and also without much or with zero programming knowledge. Okay, and the shift, this because of this, the paradigm shift of the test automation has happened and maintenance problem has been resolved. Using Tosca, most of the maintenance problem has been removed. Okay, and before going to talk about the components of Tosca and the architecture, right, let me show you Tosca. I already installed Tosca in my system. Like once you install Tosca, you get a folder created by Tricentis. Why? Because Tricentis is a company which has developed Tosca. And look at here, like there are three main components of the Tosca. One is called as Tosca Commander, other one is called as Executor, and the third one is called as Wizard. And Tosca is a licensed tool, like it's not a free open source like Selenium, it's a licensed tools, and you have to pay some licensing fees, okay, for using this particular tool. And let me open, among all the components, the Tosca Commander is a key component or the major component we call. Let me open this. So the version of Tosca which I'm using is 12.0 for this training course. It takes some time to load this tool. So this is the tool, like this is the UI. Just I want to show you some details of this tool, like these are the recent projects. This give you the access to the what are the recent projects we worked on. And if you want to know about the version, from this page, just click on the button, like click on the project section. So where you have about Tosca option. So this will tell you like what version of Tosca we are using. We are using a version called as 12.0, and it supports 64-bit operating system. And this is up to from start this version, like copyright information is 12 to 18. Okay, and these are the different functionalities which are implemented in this particular version. Okay, these details you'll be able to access. And there's one more thing called as licenses. So coming to licenses, we will talk to it later. There are different types of licenses like seat license and also the cloud license. We'll talk to it. And multiple people can work in Tosca. It's not like that only one person will be working in Tosca. So when multiple users are working on the tool, how to manage these things, we'll be looking in our class. Okay. So for time being, like we'll see some advantages, like what are the key components and features of Tosca. So let's look at the features of Tosca. Just a second. So Tosca is developed using this model-based architecture. Let me come to this point. Tosca is a third generation model which is working on a concept called as model-based architecture. So by using this model-based or model-based architecture, we can optimize the risk coverage and you can manage your test data effectively. And if you, these are some of the parameters why we should shift to Tosca. Like using Tosca, it is 10 times more effective than our conventional testing. 90% increase in test automation rates, 95% increase in business coverage, and 90% faster in the execution time. So what happens in Tosca is, like, basically you have a section called as the module section. Let me show you the module section. This is called as a module section where you scan your elements. Where if it comes to web-based application, you scan your web elements like radio button, text boxes, drop downs. So one second. So basically the Tosca, like if you look at this model based test automation, what happens is, like, create test automation models by automatically scanning the application under test. Okay, and it only one single repository is required for doing all the things like your requirements, your test cases, execution and reports. We look more practically on the model based architecture using the tool. Time being, I'm talking about one of the features of Tosca. So as I was saying, you can maintain your manual test cases as well as automation test cases in a single repository. Okay, you need not maintain separate repository for your manual test cases as well as automation test cases. Okay, and using Tosca, you can perform your UI testing as well as non-UI testing. For example, if you are using tools like open source tools like Selenium is mostly focusing on the UI part of the application. So if you want to work on something called as web services, you have to shift to other tool like SOAP UI. So you can avoid such type of complexity if you are using a tool like this, Tosca, because Tosca supports both UI testing as well as non-UI testing. And nowadays, like, people are shifting to this DevOps roles where you have this continuous integration and continuous deployment CI/CD concept. Tosca has this feature where you can work with a DevOps team. What is the use of this CI/CD model is by clicking on a single click of a button, the deployment activity starts and the code is directly pushed into the production. So these are some of the features of Tosca, like automatic recovery, recognition by image based test automation, loops and conditions, test case maintenance, test data management, and it embraces Selenium and support for Siebel also. These are some of the features we'll see later, these concepts. And this is the most important thing when it comes to Tosca. Like, Tosca is divided into six sections and each section has a different color coding. If you look at here in my tool, So these are the different sections in Tosca. Each section has a different color coding. So the test cases section is having a blue color, and the model section is having orange color, requirement is in yellow color, design is in red color, execution is in green color. And if any bugs you want to log, you have a section called as issue section. Okay, let me go to that slide. So these are called as sections or faces in Tosca. Okay, so as part of this course, right, we'll be working on each and every section. This is what the talk slide talks about, like there are six sections and each section has a different color coding. So what happens in the requirement section? Basically, the requirement section is where the BA writes the requirements, and all the requirements can be captured in the requirement section. If you look at this image, right, this image focus on the requirement section. And test design section is a section where you create your test cases. You can create both manual test cases as well as automation test cases in one single repository. And this is a core section, like the module section. The module section, what it talks about is like you have to scan the elements. You have to scan the elements in your Tosca, and what are the elements are scanned will be located in this particular section. Because if you want to test a particular application, let's say I want to test a text box. So in order to perform an action on this particular control called as text box, I need to identify that particular element, or I need to identify that particular text box. For identifying a text box or for identifying the elements on a web page or a desktop application, we have to make use of a section called as module. We'll practically see how to work on modules. Finally, we have this execution section. Once our design is completed, then we execute our test cases, and the results will be displayed. And for reporting purpose, there are different options available, like you have this list and label concept, you have this XML concept, and Microsoft Excel reports, as well as the Crystal reports. Tosca supports close to four types of reporting concepts, and there are different components like Commander, Executor, and Wizard. This will be focusing in the next class. Thank you for listening to my video.